Again for Djokovic to go into the tiebreak, holding it love.
One of his best service games. And what a time to come up with that, giving him just a little bit of momentum going into this vital tiebreak.
Del Potro winning the first set tiebreak, 7-4. And he'll begin this second tiebreak. Just pummels the serve down the middle.
Fastest serve of this set, 207.
Gave him a chance, and on the forehand, the way he's hitting it today, that's going to be the result.
Strange strategy there from Djokovic, an ill-advised approach.
Another one.
Del Potro on full stretch. Playing magnificent tennis.
He gets both points on the Djokovic serve.
Thank you, point please.
Djokovic succumbing to the constant pressure that Del Potro has applied throughout this match with the caliber of shots that he's been able to produce consistently.
Thank you.
Crushing another forehand, forcing the error. And you cannot see a way out now for Novak Djokovic. It was always going to be trouble. What? Three left, four left, five left now.
You think that it's too far to come back, but do not count him out.
Thank you. Thank you, quite please.
Just feeling there, he was coming in because everything working for Del Potro from the baseline, maybe forced to try that, Djokovic. Oh, the space was there. And the way he's been playing, you backed him to make it.
5-1. Del Potro has just played so wonderfully to get into this position. A seemingly assailable lead in the tiebreak, but closing these sorts of matches out can be so, so difficult. Djokovic is going to keep coming at him.
Yeah, the luxury that he has, though, Del Potro, is the big, big serve, able to just hit the ace or hit a big serve at the winner on the next shot.
Thank you.
As opposed to, let's say, a grinder. Match points all the way.
6-1.
I don't think their celebrations will be ending after the match. Delpo may be joining them.
Well, what a response down a match point, cracking that return.
6-2.
Desperate to keep his hopes of a career golden slam alive. It'd be a miracle.
And what was it, John McEnroe, famous tiebreak many years ago, said he'd stand on his head if Krajicek lost to his fellow Dutchman, having a 6-love or 6-1 lead. Well, it happened. What happened here? Still unlikely. He has done it with a net cord winner. But overall, on the evening, it has been a case of Delpo the Destroyer punishing tennis from Del Potro after all that he has been through. Special moment for Del Potro, and what great scenes. That was Ever the Sportsman at the net, Djokovic.
Well, what an extraordinary moment for this man, causing a huge upset here, but really making a statement with the way he went about that. He's back, and what a place to come back on the Olympic stage, upsetting the world number one. And the way he did it, breathtaking.
Exactly. I'm sure he'll be asked after what he felt about the level of his tennis, where he felt it wasn't. Listen, he played a phenomenal match. Was Djokovic 100%? Was he playing his best tennis? He may feel that he could have played better in some aspects of the game, but this is the kind of stuff that reminded us of Djokovic 2009, 2010.
Well, emotions from both men. Djokovic absolutely devastated that his dream of an Olympic gold medal is gone. Gone for now anyway. And emotions just the opposite for Juan Martín Del Potro after the agony of being sidelined by injuries for so very long. He's coming back and showing that he is a contender at the top of the game.
Yeah, just contrasting storylines. Djokovic walking off in tears, perhaps realizing that this was his last realistic chance to win an Olympic singles gold. He's going to be 33 if he's going to be in the prime in Tokyo. That may not be the case. As for Del Potro, out of the game for most of the past two seasons. And the thing about this is, looking at the draw and the way that he has played, and he has a chance. He has a chance to go much further in the draw.
Exuberance around the stadium and the Del Potro fans around the world. The moment belongs to the big man from Argentina. Such an exciting brand of tennis he played tonight. And I think there are tears throughout this stadium, anyone watching this match.
Two players on court, as well as everybody inside the stadium, will not forget this evening. Just great to see those smiles on the face of Del Potro. Not many of them over the last 3, 4, 5 years.
And the match stats, well, the story of the match was just how brilliant Del Potro was. And if you look down at those break point conversions, only 7 opportunities for Del Potro, none for Djokovic throughout the match. But-